a Malacanang website that contains information on the regime of the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr. remains inaccessible on Tuesday morning. Former Palace Communications Undersecretary Manolo Quezon first brought up that issue, but the Presidential Museum and Library asserts the website was not deleted. It adds the page was merely suspended to update its content and improve its security features. A petition has been filed before the Supreme Court seeking to nullify the looming electoral victory of presidential bet Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Civic groups asked the High Court to cancel Marcos's certificate of candidacy. They also asked the Supreme Court to issue a temporary restraining order to stop the Senate and House from canvassing the votes for Marcos in the May 9 elections. The petitioners say Marcos should not have been allowed by the Commission on Elections to run for president due to his previous conviction for tax evasion. In 1995, Marcos was convicted by the Quezon City Regional Trial Court for failure to file income tax returns and pay income taxes from 1982 to 1985. The son and namesake of the late dictator, Ferdinand Marcos Sr., holds a commanding lead in the recent polls with over 31 million votes. Well, Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio planning to take her oath as the Philippines' next vice president on June 19 in her hometown. That will be days ahead of the inauguration of presidential frontrunner Ferdinand Marcos Jr., who will likely assume office as the country's next leader on June 30, succeeding Duterte Carpio's father, President Rodrigo Duterte. The leading vice presidential candidate says her early inauguration will allow her to attend Marcos's own ceremony. The Uniteam tandem continues to hold a commanding lead in the latest unofficial tally of the Election Commission and may be proclaimed before the end of the month. A political analyst believes Duterte Carpio will do a good job when she becomes the next education secretary. Dindo Manhit of Strat-based ADR Institute says Duterte Carpio's experience as mayor of Davao City will work to her advantage.
People don't realize that mayors are actually experienced in running educational system at a very local level. Mm-mm. Because they run the local school board. In my experience of understanding the structure of public education in the Philippines is that you need to work with local. That's where the front line is. So if she can bring her experience as a mayor, work with career officials in the Department of Education,
yeah, or experts,
the technical side, to the career officials, but on her part, make the Department of Education more responsive to its stakeholders.
Duterte Carpio was among the first cabinet appointees announced by leading presidential bet Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The Marcos camp has also said they are considering appointing to government positions candidates who lost in last week's elections. The Philippine elections may be drawing to a close, but the race for the Senate presidency that has just begun. Sherian Torres now tells us at least five lawmakers are reportedly eyeing the third highest post in the land.
With a new batch of 12 senators soon to be proclaimed by the Commission on Elections, talks as to who will be the next Senate president start to heat up, with the names of Senators Cynthia Villar and Juan Miguel Zubiri said to be leading the race. Senator Sherwin Gatchalian and Senate returnees Loren Legarda and Francis Escudero are also reportedly eyeing the post. A contender needs at least 13 votes to corner the Senate presidency. In line with this, two senators told ABS-CBN News that Zubiri has already bagged the majority votes. Their colleagues' disapproval of Villar, the sources say, was due to her bad temper and her conflict of interest as a business magnet should she lead the chamber. One of the sources adds what they would not want to see at the podium is someone who is hot-headed, who doesn't know the rules, and one who doesn't observe proper decorum. The sources also claim Zubiri enjoys the backing of presumptive President Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. Sought for reaction, Villar, through her media relations officer, says it's still too early to discuss the Senate presidency. Zubiri likewise refuses to comment on the matter. But former Senator Antonio Trillanes IV, who worked with Zubiri and Villar, says his information is that Villar is leading the Senate presidency race.
Si Senator Zubiri kasi, ano to eh, Mr. Congeniality, ano? So mabait siya sa lahat eh. That may be a problem kung kailangan mong maging independent. Si Senator Cynthia Villar, ano siya eh, unifying figure kasi parang motherly yung dating, parang principal ano, sa eskwelahan.
A Senate President, according to Trillanes, must be an institution veteran and someone who enjoys the respect and good relations of his or her colleagues. He adds a Senate President is third in the Constitution's line of succession, controls the yearly budget of the Senate, and handles the SP office's confidential funds. Trillanes says the Senate President also decides what committee will be given to every member. Another unnamed Senate source also predicts a Villar victory over Zubiri, citing Bongbong Marcos's refusal to endorse Zubiri's father in the congressional race. Another supposed Villar advantage is her husband Manny's strong affiliation to both the Duterte and Marcos camps. Dr. Jean Franco of the University of the Philippines Political Science Department, who incidentally worked as a Senate legislative staff years ago, meanwhile underlines the reality of how one is chosen as a Senate president.
Kung inendorso ng presidente, that's the reality. Wala akong natatandaan naging Senate president na hindi gusto ng presidente. Do kasi importante din na na pagdating sa budget process, pagdating sa kanyang main legislative agenda, priority legislative agenda, makuha niya yung suporta ng Senate.
And whether it will be a Villar or Zubiri leadership at the Senate, the scenario will still be the same according to Franco.
Halimbawa, Senator Villar, magiging as independent, as feisty as the person is ba ang chamber?
No. No. Mm-hmm. And that's something that the entire country must watch out for.
Can you say the same thing to a Zubiri leadership?
Pareho eh. Mayroon na nakikita ko. We don't know what developments will happen in the next 3 years, pero I think the yung 30 million votes matter a lot in terms of political capital.
Senate Minority Leader Franklin Drilon, who served as Senate President for a number of years, has some reminders to those competing for the chamber's top post. An effective Senate President, he says, is a consensus builder and one who knows how to enter a compromise when crafting laws. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.